Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 1.1, Problem 1. This is Section 1.1, Problem 1. It says determine if each data set is a population or a sample, and there's 7 different data sets that we're going to make that determination for each one. So again, population would mean it's the entire group that we're interested in studying. Sample would mean it's part of the group we're interested in studying. That's the difference. So the first data set is a survey filled out about the shopping preferences for 100 Home Depot shoppers. So this should be a sample. It's not likely that anyone's interested in just those 100 shoppers at Home Depot. Probably they're doing a study for all the shoppers at Home Depot, which is impractical to study them all. So if they examine 100, they'll have an idea of what's going on. So this is a sample because it seems much more likely that it's only part of the group that you're interested in studying. The next one, B, the ages of all the presidents of the United States at the time of their inauguration. So, in this case, since there's been less than 50 presidents, you could examine them all. So the entire group that this study is interested in is all the U.S. presidents, how old they were when they took office. It seems that you can study them all. You can look at the entire group. So that would be a population. The next data set, part C, it says the speeds of 60 cars traveling on Route 24 on a Thursday afternoon. So again, what do you feel that this study is interested in studying? What's the entire group that they want to study? It's likely all the cars that travel on Route 24 to see how fast they're going. So those particular 60 on one afternoon would only be part of the group that they want to study, and being only part of the group would make that a sample. The next one, part D, the amount spent on shopping by 40 customers at Shav's Market in Fall River. So again, you have to ask, what do you think it is that this study is interested in studying? What's the entire group that they want to study? And it would seem likely that it's all the shoppers at Shav's Market. How much are they spending? So these particular 40 shoppers would only be part of the group. So being only part of the group would make it a sample. Again, you have to have the whole group in your study if you have the population. So part E, the score of the winning team for each Super Bowl. So again, there haven't been that many Super Bowls. You can look at all the Super Bowls and look at what the score was for the team that won, and you would be looking at the entire group that you're interested in studying. So it would make part E, a population. You're looking at the entire group that you want to study. That's a population. The next one, part F, the weights of 30 fish caught in the pond at BCC, right out in front of G Building. So what is it likely that this study is interested in determining? The weights of the fish in the pond at BCC. Well, all the fish would be impractical to catch. These 30 would be part of the group that you're interested in studying, which would make that a sample if it's part of the group that you want to study. So that's sample for F. And finally, the last one, the time it takes to get through the drive-through at the Dunkin' Donuts on Ellsbury Street for 25 cars. Again, if that's what you're looking at, probably the entire group that you're interested in is all the cars that go through the drive-thru at Dunkin' Donuts and how long that would take. And usually the restaurant owner wants to make that a speedy process. So by looking at these particular 25, you're only looking at part of the group that you want to study, which would make the last one also a sample.